All right, YouTube. I'm back with something. Most of you probably would have already heard of this game. This is Blood Bowl 2, and this is not really gonna be a guide or anything like I've been doing on my channel. This is more like a let's look at type of thing, and I'd like to find people to be able to play this with, because I've tried to do random, look for random matches and stuff, and haven't had too much success. So as you can see, this is a solo league I created with my team here, and here's my coach name and my Skaven team that I created, and it's kind of a beginning Skaven team that I found that works, and so I can play this video just to kind of show, this is a really good game of a really good match I had against these Wood Elves. I guess the computer is set to hard mode when you join a league, because I'm not, yeah, I just let it start. You don't get an option, but yeah, I just want to preface this by saying, you know, this is not a guide. I'm not saying like I'm the greatest Blood Bowl player or anything, but just wanted to share this with you guys. And if anybody knows of any leagues or anything I can maybe join, leave it in the comments. So here we are. I believe I kicked the ball off to them, and it's raining. But I think that rain ends as soon as the ball kicks off. Here, this is a part where I struggle. I don't know what formations. The weather changed. I don't know what formations work best. And we got lucky here. We got a touchback. So I think I gave it to the gutter runner. Yeah, I did. I feel like my opening formations I can improve on a lot. So if people know any advice for opening formations and stuff like that, even defensive formations, offensive, whatever. Oh, here, this got ridiculous. And I've gotten destroyed on here by bad luck. But to anyone that says the computer cheats with the dice, just look at how bad the rolls went for them this turn. I mean, I almost decimated. You know, this team was pretty decimated by the end. And, I mean, that's what's Skaven. You know, so nobody has Mighty Blow. We're all pretty weak armor value. And they actually have more agility. But the computer, I've noticed the computer doesn't manage agility teams very well. Like, he won't dodge out of the way. I mean, fail to roll here. I think we re-rolled. Yeah, this is a really fun game. If you like board games and stuff like that, maybe give this a look. I noticed that the reviews are like a 7 to 8 range. I mean, this is definitely a solid 8+ for me. Against Skaven, I was people criticize it a lot because of the dice rolls, but I don't find it. Every once in a while, you'll get a game where like what happened here. But I just got like insanely good dice rolls on this team and just injured and knocked out and killed everybody and whatever. But I mean, the same thing could have possibly happened to me. And in a league format, it's more you got to play through the whole season, you know, so one bad game is not the end of the world. Let's see, I think he's going to try to. Yeah, I think he injured my gutter runner. Oh, he knocked him out, so that wasn't so bad. Rat stew on the menu tonight. Maybe we will see him on the pitch later. But I know who my Skaven teams. I mark a little more with them than I will with the elves. These elf players are. You see how the elves can dodge so good. The Skaven can't do that. Like you see, you got to dodge off there, dodge. They can move around a lot. The Skaven can't really do that, even though they have low. Just as lower armor value than wood elves and dark elves, actually. I mean, not wood elves, high elves and dark elves. But, the Skaven are really extremely fast. I think that's. See what they're linemen. Yeah. They're about as fast as elves, they just don't have the same agility. And, I think they get more, All you need is the pretty tail. Interesting, I guess, the way this out, because we do get Storm Vermin, but then what else get stuff like this, you know, they get like War Dancers that have block, dodge, and leap, but then they cost a fortune, so We got pretty lucky right there. We got the block.
Within grasping range of the fans. And they're looking hungry.
Fair. I bought this along with Battlefleet Gothic Armada during the Steam sale, and I haven't even touched the Gothic Armada yet because this is so fun. Like, I've mostly been playing this in Witcher 3. They're all jumping up. There you go. I think he went for a. I think he did knock me off the pitch here. Yeah, he did. We didn't get injured though. The crowd beat us up. So yeah, that's a thing. I believe we did get a tackle here. I believe we did score our first touchdown.
He's either waiting for the ball or abusing the fans.
I see the AI was. I don't know what they. The AI thought it was gonna score or something. I don't know. So he knocks down the gutter runner here. So yeah, I don't know. It's a good idea to have people down here to score, but you see, they sent way too many people. And I thought it was gonna do some BS stuff and try to pass to this guy and then try to, you know, link it like this. I think that's what we're trying to do. Let's see, we got lucky there and got the turnover and the injury. So I was gonna say, this people that say like they AI can some games I feel like the dice kind of favor them, but not really this game at all. So I really maybe the dice really are random. I don't know. I think when people lose and then, you know, you have to roll dice like this, people can get kind of salty. Take down the ball carrier before he can move it up the field. There was another injury. We had a lot of injuries in this on both sides. A lot of armor breaks. So yeah, this was a touchdown. I'm certain nothing will go or maybe next turn. Is that my lineman? No, yeah, that's my lineman. Here we are, just throwing blocks on these elves. I was hoping if I had Frenzy, I could have pushed him off. And that's one of their key players. That's actually one of the best classes in the game. Period. The War Dancer. There we go. I think we, then I mark him. Which, that, you know, he can get out of this, no problem. Actually, all of these guys can, one of these guys can get up and mark me, and then the other one could blitz me. Now you see he's kind of panicking, or the AI is, because I'm got the ball again. So the AI can do some silly stuff, so now it's got to try to bring their whole team back over here. So he's blitzing me with a one die for some reason.
Good defensive block.
I think I actually made a pass here and then scored with the gutter runner. And there was another armor break for the AI. He just got stunned. Yeah, so now he's trying to. I have no idea why he didn't mark. See, this is why I say the AI does silly stuff. He should have got out and he should have marked my gutter runner. And he should have had this guy mark the gutter runner. So this is another armor break, another injury for him.
That wood elf looks to be rather
this next game. You think that, and this is a league that I have gone solo with the AI, so that does matter. And you see, we failed the pass, but we rerolled it.
That's what you get when you protect.
So we did get it that time. So now he's gonna score. So that was our first touchdown with my Mo Rats team.
Didn't miss the touchdown.
The Rats enjoying themselves. Here's a really lazy, this is one of my little aggravating things about this game. All of the teams have human cheerleaders that do that. And Blood Bowl 1, Chaos Edition, I noticed, I don't have it, but I was thinking about maybe getting it, because they actually have all of the teams on there. And, in this game, they're in the process of still releasing, teams. You see right here, this is kind of almost what the computer suggested, so I kind of just, I kind of just do my formations off the fly. Like, I don't really have a, here we got unlucky and got a high kick. I don't really have a, you know, a playbook per se. Like, I kind of just throw my people out here. Like, my only thing is I put my Storm Vermin on the line of scrimmage. I usually put my disposable people right here to take beatings. And I'll pull them back. So I usually pull my line, my Storm Vermin's like back. And I'll just put linemen up there. Or I'll put my big guy up here if I had a big guy. Nothing to see here. But we don't have a Rat Ogre on this team because it's just a starting team. And I don't know if, really know if I'm going to even go with the Rat Ogre or not, to tell you the truth. So yeah, he kicked my gutter run. So, yeah, it's getting pretty lucky with the dice here. So that's a armor break. Oh, yeah, a death. Yeah. Oh, okay, I remember now. Yeah. So I rerolled this injury into something else from the death. Yeah, pinch nerve, so he just mixed next game. So what happened was I had an apothecary, and I used it, and it re-rolled the death into this. So I could have either took a death, or I could have took miss next game. So I just took miss next game. But you get a lot of that with this Skaven team. They always injured. They're always getting killed and whatnot. And and he's got dodge too. These gutter runners start with dodge, which is really good. You saw what happened was I failed when I moved away from him. I failed, or like I failed, just go for it. But what happened? I failed the first dodge I tried to make against him, and so he re-rolled his own dodge. He got an injury. We had a lot of entries on both sides in this match. It was insane. And so we kind of almost caught the ball. Yeah, so you can see already they have three people over there injured. While we have none. So we got pretty lucky so far. Which that was another reason why I was kind of able to overwhelm the AI a little bit, because I had all my people. And now here I am. I'm just setting up. Probably could have set up a nice block right here, but just kind of moving our people around and whatnot, because I'm feeling, well, here I'm just trying to make sure that I'm trying to make them have as hard a time as possible of tackling this guy, which I completely forgot about this guy, and he ended up, like, running around to here. Yeah. He ran around, and he used a dodge. So what is he? Oh, he's a catcher, okay. And so for some reason, so I'm saying this computer could be kind of, oh, that was actually kind of clever on their part. What he was trying to do is he was trying to blitz my guy here is at the ball. He used the leap. He succeeded in leap, and then he failed the go for it right here, and they didn't have a reroll. Oh, they had already used the reroll. I'm not sure. One less obstacle for what happened there was I threw a defender stumble action at him. And since he has dodge, he didn't go down. That was our second touchdown. I did get a pretty ridiculous score with it against these Wood Elves. But the Wood Elves are really good at scoring as well. They're really fun. I have a Wood Elf team I've been playing with too. So that's our injured. These injured people don't come back. But the KO ones, they do dice rolls or something, and they have a chance to come back.
They've kicked the ball to the opponents. Now it's time to think defensively.
See, I guess the AI just uses preset formations or something. I don't know. Since I've just been playing AI, I don't really. Oh, we got lucky here. We got a blitz, which means we get to go before the ball comes down. So we can dodge there. And he has really good agility, so what I'm trying to do here is have him catch the ball just to cause problems for them. And I'm marking here. I'm gonna mark probably. I think I tackle this guy.
This is going to be decisive.
Yeah, I KO him. Well, KO dice anyway. And I believe I put somebody up here to try to assist with this. Yeah. We actually did 2 go for it right there, which is pretty lucky. And I believe I just marked people to try to, you know, just so they at least have to do a dice roll to get away from me. Oh, we slipped here. I don't know if I rerolled or not. No, I must not have. Oh, so, yeah, we didn't even catch the ball, even though, you know, 4 agility. So now they're trying to recover here. So kind of what I was hoping for here is maybe that one of these L's would fail a dodge roll, and I would be able to, you know, do more up here. There you go, he KO'd a gutter runner. Which there, you know, 7 armor value is really low. Well, pretty low. We don't have like halflings and stuff in here yet, which I understand to be like a really flimsy team. Yes, the unmistakable sign of a player's eyes. So he just got a push right here. So they're trying to. So you see, the AI is really not that bad. So they're trying to come up here and surround the ball, but they managed to get it back. So they kind of left this guy open. So I believe I'm gonna try to dodge out here and then blitz him and knock the ball loose. Yeah, I think I may have tried to pick the ball up with the gunner on, and then we slipped again, which is a go. Which this happens when you try to do a go for it roll. And I must have not had any rerolls left. Let's see. That happens when you try to do go forwards, which is you see I have 7 movement allowance, but I can move up to 9 if I want to make dice rolls for it to see if I succeed or not. And as long as you don't roll a 1, I think you get to move. If you roll a 1, you fall and you can get injured and stuff like that. So here was another KO. So you can see all the insane amount of armor breaks we had. Night. Don't let the bed bugs bite. So I got lucky here. This was, he rolled a 1 out of 6. So, but he had a reroll available, so he failed the first time. He used his team reroll, which he's out of now. And then now he succeeded. So they kind of, you know, the AI kind of fucked up here. Like this is really skimpy defense. So I think what I did here, I just blitzed this guy with a 2 dice block.
They're going for the ball.
Yeah, and we both. Yeah, I did it both down. And I just did that just to possibly injure. I could have gotten injured, but I was trying to really injure him, or you know, just to get the ball loose again, so they'd have to pick it up again. And I got 2 people, the ball's in these 2 guys' tackle zone, so I think that's a minus. What do you want to show me? I think that means this is a -2. Or whatever they roll trying to pick this up, -2. And you can see we're already at halftime. Okay, so he got a KO on me right here. But no injury, no arm break. Okay, so they got the ball. So he's trying to free up down here so he can make like a pass or something. Which he does, KO my thrower. Or stun him. I don't see what he didn't have. So the AI probably would have met a scored right there if they had another turn. So we had 1 injury and I think 2 knockouts. Or 1 knockout because 1 guy got up. That's what I mean, like these guys won't ever get up again. But if they're KO'd, like they could possibly get up.
They're down a player. Easy to run.
Yeah, I just you know. Important thing, gotta keep possession of. You know, I don't really have this way I think my strategy kinda fails me. I don't have a really good any really good formation strategies. Like I probably should have moved this guy up a little bit. He could possibly. I didn't really want him to. I kind of keep him back because he's a thrower. I'd rather he not suffer some kind of permanent injury or something. The team have possession. And so because they're elves, the whole team's like 4 agility, so they usually don't have any trouble passing or dodging or anything. So what happened there? That was a both down on the dice. But because this guy here, my gutter runner doesn't have block, wrestle or anything. He took the it became like a KO for him because he has block, and so both down doesn't work on him. So both down will trigger block, and then it'll just knock my character down. That doesn't have if he, since he didn't have block that time. Like we both had block, it'll just been like a tie. There's a lot of stuff like that in this game. There's a lot of skills and stuff to learn.
They're going for the ball.
So here we had a. Is that a one die? Must have been, yeah. So I got lucky here and got a one die block on him, and I'm gonna try to pick the ball up.
The player could spit into
the end zone. I think I tried to just like separate and put tackle zones here to try to separate the two teams from each other. Well, I marked here. Yeah, so I just tried to mark. But ideally, you would want to put like some guys right here to set up tackle zones. And a tackle zone is the area around your player. So you'd want to just put people here to try to separate, so you know, so they couldn't get people to the ball if possible. You know, like I don't want these guys to come up here. See, like he's doing, and then he's gonna stand up. So I tried to tie his players up because it was 2-1 up here. It was 2-1, and we got lucky with that. He failed that tackle. So yeah, that was really, really lucky right there. I don't think he had turnovers. Oh, he did. So if I was the AI right there, I probably would have gone ahead and used the turnover because these other L's would have probably succeeded. And he could have possibly, you know, he would have outnumbered me. And he would have wrestled the ball or gotten the ball away from me. Because my people were still down.
Let's hope Nuffle is smiling on those blocking dice, Bob.
So you see, the AI is smart enough to reroll double skulls, which is attacker down. But like right there, right there they couldn't do anything because they rerolled that. And that's what the normal result of a both down is if nobody has skills. Which I don't think. Yeah, we neither one of us. And so now you can see it's getting kind of crowded up here. This guy can probably hand off and do a touchdown if he doesn't stand up.
The ball, carrier, Bob.
I know,
so here I got lucky. We just got a push, so it wasn't that bad.
Ball in danger.
And we got lucky again here with another push.
It was time.
So, if he would have had strip ball, maybe we got lucky with this tackle too. So, oh, we killed his war dancer. So that was insane. Like we killed this war, one of his best players. So that, I think that player cost 110,000 gold. So that really, this was kind of like the beginning of the end for him. We already 2-0, and we just killed one of their best players. So here I am right here. I'm trying to and we just injured him. So, but yeah, that's to be expected because you see 7 armor value. So what I'm doing here, I'm trying to get pressure off of my guy so he can do that. And so we scored again. And it would have been harder if I wouldn't have knocked that other elf down. He would have had to dodge out of a minus 2 tackle zone instead of what that was, just minus 1. There's the boring cheerleaders. I really wish they would make some more cheerleader models. So we got lucky and both of our people woke up. And you can see this is all people that's not coming back. So he's down 5 players. And I have, I believe, my full team still. Or maybe minus 1. Yeah, he's minus. I still got what I had. So I was down 1 player. And he was down like 5. So we're just setting up again. Now, probably if I had my Storm Vermin, I'll put him here. I would put him with the Gutter Runner or something. So here we got lucky and we got an extra reroll because of the random event, which was cheering fans. And you can already see, you know, being down 5 players, it's going to be hard for him to even throw blocks.
Oh, the ball has been lost.
That was really unfortunate for him. That's why I say the bad stuff does happen to the AI. And the AI can do some pretty dumb stuff. So he threw a block and got a KO dice on my lineman. You can see it takes 2 elves to get a 2 dice roll. Because they need assists. And I need assists too. But the problem with them As you can see, they don't have that many people left. So I can throw more blocks on them than they can on me. So see, he's being kind of aggressive here, which I wouldn't have. I would have surrounded the ball with a cage. You see, he just left the ball carrier wide open, but AI did anyway. We got lucky there with a dodge.
This could be fun, especially if the ball holder.
So here we knock the ball loose again. And so there's the ball, and I believe my gutter runner came and picked it up and ran a little bit more with it.
Touchdown is near.
Yeah. And he ran up a little bit. So yeah, now I'm just trying to tie up these few L's. He only has 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 L's, or 5 and the one that's down right here. So he could have blitzed me right here and got a 2-die block, but I think he might have got bad dice rolls right there or something, or he got something I could dodge out of. So there's my thrower moving up a little bit. I believe the AI, so this is probably the smartest move. No, he didn't. And then we got lucky right here again. But that's my kind of strategy on elves. Make them dodge a lot. Because they're going to dodge. Even if you're playing against humans, they like, that's their best. So he did get the ball back. He KO'd my gutter runner. Wow. Rat stew on the menu tonight. I like that.
Smacked a player to relieve his team.
So you can see how easy, these are both two fragile teams. Wow, so that was a turnover because he fumbled the ball trying to pick it up. So I believe we started marking a little bit and then we went to try to pick the ball up ourselves. Or we may have blitzed this guy because that would be the best thing to do to knock him off of the, we didn't.
Taking the ball from right under the opposing team's nose.
I don't know why I didn't blitz him. That was been a good idea. They were just throwing blocks on the War Dancer, trying to get rid of the other one too. If I wanted to, I could foul him, but he was already. If I would have started fouling right here, that I think that would have just been a dick move. So here we rerolled that. Which honestly, I really didn't. That was kind of a waste of a reroll. Now that I'm looking at it. But we had 4 rerolls. We only have, you have to use them one a turn, so maybe that's probably why I did it.
Like a brown streak.
See, now we have one. We have a one reroll for each turn that's left. So yeah, they knocked me down here.
Killed the fool carrying the ball.
See, he should have came forward and tried to pick the ball up. See what I'm saying? AI does some silly stuff. Cause he blitzed with this guy, so that means he could have tackled and then came and picked the ball up. And we get lucky here with another tackle. And an injury.
Snapped like a twig.
So that was another injury. Wow. So you can see their all that their injury box is like getting full. I don't know what happens if you ever fill up the injury box. So here we're gonna probably blitz this guy, I think. Yeah, we blitzed him. Then I believe I picked it. Is this a gutter runner? Oh, this is the gutter runner. I believe I picked it up with the gutter runner after. Yeah, we got the knockdown because he didn't have dodge. So we're gonna come in with the gutter runner and I think score again. Yeah. This is what, 4 to nothing, man. So really, this one like my personal best against the AI. And here we go, the same, you know, come on, guys. You can't do better than this. The same cheerleaders with no facial animations. They just kind of sit there. They did a really good job on the player AI models. Well, not the AI models, but the player models, you know. I like those. I like the way these goblins, I like the way the stadium's looking, everything.
Fresh start, fellas.
Just don't like the way the cheerleaders look.
With one team having a 3,
so we kick it off again.
Can't see how
he has, oh yeah, this was really bad for the AI. the pitch invasion from the fans. So what happened was some randomly selected players are stunned, which means that they won't be able to act for two turns. So take a look at what happened here. His whole team gets stunned, except for this guy. The ball's right here. So he tries to run and get the ball.
Up the ball with ease.
One of my characters got stunned. His whole team got stunned. So now none of these players can act until next turn.
This could be a sack.
So now we go, we pretty easily kick him, take the ball from him.
They'll need to get rid of the ball. Now there's pressure on them. They can dislodge the ball from that.
Yeah,
they're in with a
pretty
chance
easy.
Of turning this match on its head.
We got lucky here because that was a failed catch. And that would have caused a turnover, and then these guys could have got back up, but then he caught the ball, so they kind of secured it for me. Now I'm just marking these guys, because they're going to be getting up next turn. So I'm probably just going to mark them all with my players. And since you have, so many players, I could put a lot of tackle zones around them. I could put, minus two tackle zones and stuff on them. You see what I did? If he jumps this way, it's a minus two tackle zone. If he goes here, it's a minus one. I think he has to. I think it's him leaving out of a minus two tackle zone. Still kind of confused a little about how the tackle zones work. So we just made a reroll there just to use it. Which I find four rerolls to be plenty enough. So once your team gets the four rerolls, I'd say just stop there just to keep your team value down. So I believe I did score one more time, which was ended up being 5-0.
Nice. Very nice. Can the player force possession away from the ball holder?
Did get the ball out of my possession here.
Block on the ball carrier. Well, actually, you can do a lot of harm. That's kind of the point.
So did we just knock? I blitzed him and then I got the ball. Well, I didn't have to blitz. So we knocked him down. Yeah. I think we injured him too. No, just a stun. Luckily for that Wood Elf team. So yeah, this was another touchdown. Just to show you how fast these rats can score. Another touchdown. 5-0. You can see how fast you get XP and stuff for every injury and touchdown and pass that you make. So you can see how fast you can get XP with these Skavens.
They can't catch up such a big gap. An incredible match.
That was the end of the match.
On more than one occasion.
This was my MVP, and they got a little extra experience, and this was his MVP. So yeah, guys, just wanted to kind of show you guys this game. I've been having a lot of fun with. It's been playing for about 2 weeks, and if anybody wants to play this for friendly matches, or if anybody knows any leagues or anything I could join, just let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, let me know. I'll put more Blood Bowl up if you guys like to see it. But remember to leave a like, comment, subscribe. It really helps me out, and I'll talk to you guys later.